Hello, everybody, and welcome back. It's Banjo-Tooie. How's everybody doing this? Fine, whatever time it is where you are. Welcome back. We are in Grunty's Industries, and we're going to continue on through this. Thanks for being patient with these episodes. Love to spread things out. You know me. The consistency, while is key, is not in my blood. The only thing in my blood is copious amounts of caffeinated beverage. So what else? What did we do last time? I got a move. There's at least two more move in this area. Let's do that first. Let's do a scoop. Can we do a scoop? I feel like we should scoop so that we can start unlocking more moves. I think that's probably the best place to start, is like get a move and do a thing with the move. Again, I'm very excited about this level. It feels like infiltrating, you know, like a big corporation. You're like a spy. Come here, battery. I wish to scoop you. Oh wait, I wish to smack you and then scoop you. Scoop. Yeah, I don't know. It feels really good. It just feels really good. It's such a diverse level too. There's a lot going on here, and the boss is really cool. We'll probably do the boss like pretty quick actually, because this is one of those levels where you sort of need to do the boss to unlock some other stuff, to make some progression. Kind of. There's like a bunch of jiggies you can get from doing the boss early. Hi Kazooie, how's it going? So we got these batteries. Access denied. Door has insufficient power to open. Why are you talking so slowly? Okay, well, I've got a battery. Here you go. Pop it in. Additional battery power channeled to door. See, he's walking. He's talking like so much faster now. I don't know why he talks so much slower when he's... I think there's a split pad in there. It doesn't matter. We're just going to go in. Because I know for a fact that Banjo, it's a Banjo-only move here. Ta-da! What's up, dude? Snooze pack! When you're feeling rather low, I know a place that you can go. L or RC followed by right stick removes the pack to have a nap to get an energy back. Dude, the flow! The flow! Man, this is why I should only play the original ever. Jam Jars was throwing bars in the original Banjo-Tooie, and now he's got LT and RT. Anyway, so if you do this, you can like recharge Banjo's health. Oh, it's already full because I just talked to Jam. Jam of the Jar. Let's open this. I don't know what this does. Oh, it just brings the stuff up. Oh, we can't do this yet. There is something you can do here. In order to get this jiggy, you need to take Banjo only over there. I'm trying to remember how to do this skip. What are you doing? How did that even work? Get out of here. No, literally, get out of here. Oh, it's the gas! I hate these enemies. Least favorite enemy in the game, because then they just have these permanent gas clouds that float around. So obviously this acid is gonna kill me if I do it right. I don't have the move necessary to get over there, but I think there might be a way to sort of cheat your way over. But I can't remember what that is. Because, yeah, when it hurts you, it flings you back. But I think I don't have the correct move for that either, so I guess we just won't worry about that. I guess we just won't do anything with that. Oh, it's not on this side. That's okay. We'll come back. I think there's, is there one more Banjo-only move in this level? Or is that in the next world? That's in the next world. But we can go there now is the thing, right? So like, if you wanted to, this is the thing about the backtracking in this game. If you really wanted to, you could like jump around between the worlds. Jesus Christ with this. jump around between the worlds and get all the moves. I mean, you'd have to get notes too, I suppose, to unlock the moves early. But I mean, you don't need that many notes, I feel. You usually, I mean, currently I have all the notes in the game up to this point, and all of the moves are like 100 notes less, or, you know, than I need, or than I have, I should say. Oh, you know what else we can do? Do I have to turn something on here? No, we can just take Banjo and go in. We need Banjo for this. Time to be trash. Compact me. Intruder in the trash compactor. Cleanup droids report to floor one. Okay, there are no cleanup droids. I don't know I think that's a bluff. There are no cleanup droids. The only thing that's gonna stop me here is the fact that it is a literal trash compactor. Ow! Shit. Owie. Ouch. I need a little nap to heal my skull and all of the bones in my entire body. Just give me a little nappy poo. This is the theme of today's video. Banjo takes a nap. Ouch. Fortunately, I think it can only hit you once while you're on here. I do love how it just squishes just his head down flat. Do a little nappy. We only need to gain one health though, because it takes you up. It automatically just takes you down to one health every time. There she blows, 52 jiggies. We're moving up on the world. Boom. God, I love the mysterious, like when you're in the back rooms of this level, how the music gets sort of quiet and mysterious. This really is one of the levels that has like the greatest jams of the whole game, honestly. Very, very memorable jams in this level. No. Banjo's so mad that he can't nap anymore. It's okay, you'll get another chance, Banjo. All right, let's grab Kazooie. I think maybe we'll just go do the boss immediately. What do you think? Can we do that? It's down in the air conditioning plant. I just think that this is the best idea because, wait, no, because I have to open the door, don't I? Frick. That's right. There's more to this than meets the eye. I have to open the door. Okay, we'll come back. I forgot about that. I forgot that there's like a whole series of events to get to the boss in this one. It was definitely backwards in my head. I was like, oh, I gotta do the boss to like activate the power in the world, right? No, not a chance. Not a chance. It's okay, we get to use our sticky shoes. Oh, wait. We can do this stuff in this crew's quarter, right? Workers' quarters? I think we can do some of the stuff here at least. Oh, shoot. The fellas are here. What's up, Rabbit?
Look at the state of my overalls. They'll be in real trouble if I can't find a way to getting them clean.
I actually have a funny story about these guys. And I wonder if my parents remember this. They probably don't. When I was a kid, this game came out when I was, what, like seven, eight? And when I first played this game, and like I would do this for other characters too, but I really enjoyed like mimicking the sounds and the animations of the characters in the game. So I saw these guys and I was like, oh, cute bunny. I love his hat. I want to be this bunny. But he's sad, right? So I would go around the house going, and just kind of like hanging my head and like crying or whatever. And I remember my parents getting legitimately concerned that something was wrong. I don't even know if I explained it to them. I was like, I'm the rabbit, you know, the rabbit from Banjo. I'm just being the rabbit. Nothing's wrong. Anyway. I don't want to be alone in this. Did any of you also, like, pretend to be the characters in these games when you were young? I feel like I need to kill you. But if you open next to me, ow. Sir? Open. Open wide. There we go. Oh, they're gonna keep coming, aren't they? All right. Hold up. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna get rid of the camera. Where is the camera? Which corner is this camera in? I think you can see it from here, right? Yeah, there it is. And then we'll take these guys out. And then I can actually, like, show you some Easter eggs in this room. Like, for example, the BTBK logos, the Rareware logo, and a Jet Force Gemini logo. I'm not sure what that one is. Is that Perfect Dark? I think that might be a Perfect Dark logo. That's like Jet Force Gemini, I think. And Banjo-Tooie. Are they, did they already respawn? Are you freaking kidding me? My brother in Christ, stay dead. Whoops. Oh, hello. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to blow up the bathroom. Yo, it's Longo, our boy. Toilet man himself, Longo.
Hey there, Banjo.
Longo, what are you doing here?
Well, Grunty ripped me out of her mansion and stuck me in here. Boy, you should see the mess some of those workers make. Oh, I don't want to know. Anyway, someone thought it funny to fill me full of paper. I really need unblocking, if you wouldn't mind.
We do, actually. Ew. Wait, what does he say now?
I'm all blocked up. Help.
Then call a plumber. Hey! Wait! That one Italian plumber isn't doing much at the moment. Ah, that's funny. Oh my god. It had been a number of years since the last 3D Mario, because the last 3D Mario before this was Mario 64. Like, there wasn't another 3D Mario until Sunshine on the GameCube. Unless you count, like, Paper Mario.
I guess you can have it.
There you go. All right, wait, these guys came back, probably. Yeah. There's one more Easter egg. Oh, I thought for sure you could talk to somebody here. I thought for sure you could go up to this door and it would be like, there's a person in there talking about, like, taking a dump or something. I thought for sure that was a thing. Maybe I'm crazy. Oh, hello.
Try looking here for the filthy workers.
One outside the back door, on the floor one, floor two, floor three, spoiler plant, floor five, in the room next door. Just a little hint at where the dirty ass workers are. Can I look around? Can you not look? I guess while you're bouncing on the bed, you can't. I'm surprised they didn't put, like, extra Easter eggs in here, to be honest with you. This is a level that feels like it would be ripe with Easter eggs, honestly. Just because, like, there's a lot of little side rooms. I feel like it would be really easy to hide some Easter eggs in here. So yeah, there's another worker up there. We'll be able to fix their issue soon. We came from the train station, so okay. We've done everything we can do on the first floor with our current move set. Let's head up. See, this is the thing I like, right? Like, you can't just immediately go to floor two. There is an elevator there. Right down there. But you can't immediately go up it. Like, all of the floors are locked. So we'll go in there at some point, I'm sure. What's up here? notes, probably, maybe? Nope, eggs. I'm gonna refill on grenades while I'm here. Okay. Onwards to floor two. God, the transformation in this level is also another one that's like very, very iconic in the general Banjo franchise. Hi, bye. That's what I say to you. Speaking of the transformation, look who we found. We should probably do that right away too, huh? Well, let's get this. And there's a couple things I want to open up first. We're not even going to bother. We're not going to bother destroying them for every room, because they're just, they come back so fast is the problem. Like, I wonder if there's any other enemies in the game that respond as quickly as these stupid cameras. Oh, wait, can I not open this? Oh, I think that opens by a button. That opens with a button. Silly goose. Reminding myself what's down here. This is the exit, right? Oh. Okay, yeah, sick. I needed that to be open anyway. I could have opened it with the transformation, but yeah. Okay, we'll go out there in a second. Actually, there is one thing we can get out there with Banjo and Kazooie while I'm thinking about it, while I'm stinking on it. Okay, so push button. Open up the entirely useless fire escape that leads nowhere to reveal the black Jinjo. Oh shit, we got a split. Whoopsies. Oopsie daisy. Okay, we'll come back. Oh, there's another Jinjo up here. Yo, what's up, fella? Oh, you're evil. Okay, die. Oh, I know what's here too. Yeah, there's a fly pad there eventually. Again, more things we need to unlock. There's a lot of buttons and switches that activate things in this game, and I think, or in this level, and I think that's one of the reasons why people get so confused. It's not like you can't just go anywhere you want. There's a lot of stuff to unlock, doors to unlock, which again is reminiscent of like you're breaking in, you're like a spy, like sneaking into the corporation, trying to find the secrets of Grunty's evil corporate terror. Or something, you know. Do 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 do. Oops, almost just got electrocuted. Hate when that happens. Oh, you know what we can do? There's a move in here. Let's get that first. We're gonna hear that alarm go off so many times in this level. Wake up. I should make that my alarm sound, actually. I think that's already a built-in alarm sound in the iPhone, though, isn't it? Leg spring. Want this one? I think you might. It greatly increases your jumping height. Hold down LT or RT, and then press A. Bend your legs and be on your way. That'll be all. Dismissed. Nope, didn't mean to talk to you. It's kind of cool. It kind of reminds you how to do the moves. Okay, so leg springs very useful. So a lot of people were saying like, hey, you can do this. When I was trying to use when I was trying to get the eggs in Pterodactyl Land, they're like, can't Kazooie jump like super high? No, you gotta unlock that shit. There's a lot of basic moves. Like, that's the thing, right? Like, there's a lot of basic moves that you have to learn. Just like kind of like the first game, I feel like a lot of your basic moves you learned, you know, especially a lot of them in like the tutorial area you go and you have to learn them. Oh, I need that battery, actually. Briga! Oh, there's a Cheeto page back there, too. Jump. No, don't fall! Banjo! Woo! Nice save. Nice save. Grab it. This level also has some of my favorite minigames in the game, too. Some of the ones that are actually fun. Like, I feel like a lot of the games are just like, here's this shooting game, and there's that in this too, but it's like a little bit different. So I'm excited to get to some of that stuff. So far, I'm pretty proud of myself at remembering to do things. Ooh, electromagnetic chamber? Electromagnet chamber? That's scary. Additional battery power channel to the door. Access is now granted. Thanks, brother. God, I think there's even more that I need to do before I can even transform. Like, I'm 90% sure I need to get Mumbo involved. Here, let's open this, too. Just to make sure I don't forget to open this. That's right. Danger, danger. High voltage. When we touch, when we kiss, when we touch.
Danger, danger. High voltage.
Okay, there we go. Now we've got easy access to second floor anyway, outside of the teleporter. So we get this big button. I'm going to touch it and just show you. Sensors indicate insufficient weight to activate switch. Man, if only I was Banjo from the beginning of Nuts and Bolts. I think that would be sufficient weight at that point. But then up here, there's this panel up here, and I think there's a Mumbo pad on it, so we're gonna have to drop that down somehow in order to do all the things. So I think I need to go to the third floor now. Let's just go see what's inside of, oh, it's so creepy. The shaft is so creepy. Like, look at this. Look at how high up this goes. This is such an impressively scary room. Each floor is color coded. They're all locked off though. If you go in here, you can't get in. But you can get a sneak preview of what it's all about. Water tanks, there's a guy. There's that. I think that's actually the thing that drops the Mumbo pad down, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. So we do need to go to the third floor, like, immediately. And we should be able to get there from somewhere on the second floor, right? So let's take another gander at what we have available to us. So there's that. There was a... Okay, I'll just go through here. There was that door that was blocked. So, like, I think this is an entrance to this floor, but you can't leave through it. Like, you can drop down from the third floor through this pipe somewhere, but you can't go back up of it. Back up of it. Then there's this room here. This is where I came in. Also can't go back through that. Just kind of getting my bearings again. Evil! Stay away from me, demon spawn! Dude, I'm having a great day. Things are good right now, man. Life is good. Hopefully everybody watching is having a good time, too. This is a very chill episode, I'm sure. Now, hold up, though. There's a battery down here. Do I need that battery immediately? I think I'm gonna need that battery, but I think I have to bring it to a different floor. I'm gonna zoom the camera out a little bit because I just realized how close it was to Banjo. I was like, I can't see anything! I'm zoomed up in on Banjo's cheeks. what's up, dude? Isn't there a button somewhere? Let's open this door. Is it all the way in? What a strange place to put a vent door button. Okay, so we can go back that way if we want. That'll give us access to a split pad too. So if we wanted to split up, grab the battery, and then go to the next floor, we could do that, but I'm not gonna do that because I think there's a more easily accessible split pad. If my memory is serving me correctly. Yeah, there's one right there. So we'll use that. There's the globo. Should probably grab that first too, just so we have it for Mumbo. So what does Grunty produce here? Junk? Like, this is like a storeroom, right? This is a box of junk. There's a box of big O pants, just large underwear. What else does she produce here? Is that it? Like, she makes junk and large underwear. Why does she need to produce her own large underwear? Who's she selling it to? There are so many, I have so many questions. So many questions. Like, her clientele are probably like Klungo. Weird Al. Not Weird Al, Big Al. And I'm trying to think of other big characters. Conga. Old rubbish. Maybe you just want to, like, get rid of that stuff, you know? I don't know. Okay, we're gonna explore this floor a little bit further later. Just gonna come in here real quick and grab the warp. Oh, that's right, I do need to drop the thing down, don't I? Oh, there's another battery on this floor, too. How many freaking batteries are there? I'm so used to bringing the battery from that first floor, or from the second floor up. There is another battery there. Oops. Okay, hold on. Let me see here. So there's the boiler plant. We want to go there. That's where the, What's in there? I feel like that's important. Okay, it is important. Let's go get that real quick. I think I need Kazooie to do that, though. Oh my god, there's so many things that I want to grab immediately. Okay, let's go get the one thing that I'm thinking. Yeah, we won't be grabbing Mumbo or doing any of that until a later time, I think. I was hoping we could get some of that stuff done in this episode so we could, like, do the boss in the next one, but that's okay. I think we'll still manage to get the boss in the next video. So yeah, Kazooie can jump higher on the jump pad, so we need her to get up here. Actually, that you might be able to make that with Banjo and Kazooie, actually. That's actually not as high as I expected it to be honest. I'm trying to remember where the... I guess it's in the boiler plant. Oh, it's in the boiler plant. We talked about this already. Hold up. Hold the phone. Yeah, let's go there. Because the thing that I need is there. Ooh, little tightrope walk. Little tightrope walk. Oh, my depth perception. You know, the 3DS solved a very specific problem for me. I have struggled, and like, I feel like I'm pretty good at 3D platformers, but I still have moments where I'm like, I can't tell where I am in 3D space. And the 3DS solved that very specific problem for one generation of gaming. I doubt we'll ever go back to 3D gaming, besides, like, outside of VR, you know? I think VR is probably the evolution of that, right? I was thinking a lot about VR and AR the other day because of the Apple Vision Pro coming out, the $3,500 Apple VR AR headset. I was thinking a lot about VR and AR as a result of that. And, yeah, man, I don't know. I'm interested in it, but it's just so expensive and inaccessible, and it, like, doesn't really solve any problems, if that makes sense. Hold up. There's an entrance to the shaft. Release the shaft. Cool. Yeah, it doesn't really solve any problems, you know? I feel like it's not that useful. Especially in a world where, like, we have screens all, like, all around our life. Why add virtual screens to it as well? It's cool, but, like, my best use case for it would be, like, I'm gonna lay in bed and just have, like, a giant screen in front of me. All right, we're gonna stop it here. We're gonna talk to Mumbo, do some fun things with Mumbo McJumbo on the next exciting video. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being here. I appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you for supporting on Patreon. And guys, I'll see you in the next episode of Banjo-Tooie. Probably tomorrow. I'm gonna keep playing.